Africa's health indicators remain behind those of other continents, and major inequities exist across the continent and within countries. In particular, in sub-Saharan countries, there exists double burden of infectious diseases and the rapidly growing epidemic of non-communicable diseases. Factors related to poverty include malnutrition and maternal mortalities further aggravate the health challenges. Ladies and gentlemen, the opportunity presented herein are vast and can be used in turn to turn around current trajectories of our health indicators. Technology presents a unique and an unprecedented opportunity. Technology can be used for education, for promoting disease control and prevention, and to improve access and quality of treatment to reach the most vulnerable of the society. I therefore urge private sector who are here to innovate to and utilize emerging opportunities for public-private partnership to develop solutions, and governments will provide the necessary platforms to deliver for all, I believe, on behalf of the Kenya government.
The Lancet Commission was prompted by the realization that Africa had a great potential to develop or improve health services and the state of health on the continent on its own terms and largely using its own resources. The Commission had a vision, and this is the vision that was articulated. By 2030, Africans should have the same opportunities for long and healthy lives that new technologies, well-functioning health systems, and good governance offer people living in other continents. On other continents, people are enjoying what many in Africa do not.
In order for us to reach the millions that we're talking about, we need partnerships, and partnerships that go beyond the health community, and partnerships with the private sector that take us back to a conversation around prevention. And what more can you do in terms of changing the behaviors of millions of communities around the world on hand washing with soap? So, you know, yes, I talk a lot about hand washing with soap because we are the world's largest soap company. So I guess that's probably the best thing that we can do is give you soap. So the evidence is very clear. We can achieve some impact in terms of reducing of diarrheal disease, acute respiratory infection. But I believe that if you can stop even one child from not going to school because he's managed to avoid the flu, isn't that worthwhile? And I think ultimately for me, it's about making sure that hand washing with soap is at the center of our new social norms, and that hygiene therefore becomes one of these prevention mechanisms that you can actually talk about.
I would say, you journalists, you can save more lives than we doctors. Because before there were drugs, it was communication, education, creating an environment, and that still is very important, very important. But I think the big opportunity, so we need to work with whoever controls and writes or works in the media, but then we have the social media. And you can be negative, okay, they made that Trump is elected and things like that, and not, but there are also very positive opportunities that we can have, and we haven't really maximized that. And that's that goes from, you know, streaming what's going on here. But what strikes me when I walk around, how young people all over the world is the same language, and they're very fast and so on. And getting into that system, I think, is going to be extremely important for many things, and also for the new challenges in that we've confronted with in health.